So we have finished working with our front end of our app. Now it's time to work on the back end of our app. So in upcoming two or three videos, we will be working just on the back end, right? Okay. So in order to test those endpoints which we will create in Node.js, we will be using this Postman, right? If you don't have installed this Postman on your machine, just go ahead to the postman.com and install it, right? And we will be using MongoDB, right? Very shortly we will set up this MongoDB, but for now let's set up Node.js. So just go navigate to employee app directory, and here just click this folder button and name it as server, right? Okay, in this server file, let's name, create a file, or we can just open terminal in our server folder. So just navigate to employee directory and click this server, click here and type cmd. This is the shortcut to open terminal in the server directory. Now first command you need to type is npm init, right? Oh sorry, not init, npm, right? Okay, so it will ask for the package name. Let it press enter. Okay, now this will create a package.json, right? Okay, now we need to install a couple of dependencies or package, right, in our project. So let's install it right now. So we'll be using npm for that. So let's type npm install, and we'll install. So we'll be using express, right? And we'll be using body parser because we'll be making post requests from the front end. So in order to parse those, we need to use body parser, p-a-r-s-e-r, body, p-r-s-e-r, and we will be using mongoose to connect with our MongoDB, m-o-n-g-o-o-s-e. It's so hard to explain and type at the same time. M-o-n-g, okay, make sure spelling is correct and hit enter. Yeah, so we'll be using these three packages only as of now, I think. And express is basically the framework, right? Yeah. So now let's open up a VS Code and now open a app. Okay, so in this app, create a file, let's name it as app.js, right? So let's write some Node.js code. So let's require express first. Express equal to require express, yeah, this one. And now let's invoke that express. So const app, and then invoke this as express like so. And let's require body parser, b-o-d-y-p-a-r-s-e-r. So I have made a p capital, right? So keep an eye on my camel casing. Require and require body parser like so. And let's require mongoose as well, const m-o-n-g-o-o-s-e, mongoose equal to require, and that will be mongoose, not like that, mongoose like so. Yeah, so now let's first set up MongoDB, I think. Or now for let's just run our server. So for now we will just type npm listen, right? Listen, and we need to give some port. So let's say 3000, right? And then we can fire a callback, right? And this in callback we can just console.log and server are you double ni running, and let's make a default route, right? So app dot get route, and let's make a default slash route, and here we can give callback function that will take two arguments, request and response. And in this callback function we will send res.send a simple text, let's say welcome to Node.js, right? Okay, now in order to run this server, you can use node or you can use nodemon. So if you haven't installed nodemon, just type npm npm install nodemon, and you can install it globally, right? Or you can install it locally. I have installed globally because I use nodemon in my every project, right? So what we can do is we can run this app with the nodemon, node mon NodeMon and I can type the file name app, right? Now what NodeMon does is it automatically reloads our app file as soon as we made change in it, right? So yeah, so have we made a console? I haven't saved this file. So if I save this, so this will automatically reload, right? So it automatically reloads, and now we can see server running is printed. Okay, yeah, if you want you can go to this localhost 3000 and you can say welcome to Node.js. Okay, awesome. Now let's set up MongoDB right in this video. So just go to this mongodb.com cloud atlas and you can start free or sign up. I have already my account, so I will just sign up. I will find from where to log in. Here. So I'll just log into my account and I will resume the video. I should pause my video and I will resume it after logging in. So I have logged into my account. So I will click on this Mukesh.org and I will create a new project, right? And I have a couple of projects, previous projects, right? So I will create a new project and let's give it project name employee app, like so, and click on next. And yeah, just hit create project. And it says to create a cluster, so just click on this build cluster and just click on this free thing, right? How to click on this create a cluster. Select AWS or Azure, whatever you want. Select free tier, this country where free tier is available. So I'm selecting this default one. You can change the cluster name if you want, right? And make sure here free, it has written free here, and just create a cluster, right? Okay, so it will take a time. It says it takes 1 to 3 minutes to create a cluster. So let me pause my video and I will resume as soon as cluster creates. So a cluster is created. Now click here in network access and add your IP address. Now if you click here add current IP address, it will automatically assign your machine IP. Now it will only allow the access to your machine, right? But for now I will allow access from anywhere, right? Yeah, you can use this as well. You can allow only your machine to access this your database, or you can allow access from anywhere. Yeah, so I will use allow access from anywhere for now, right? You can do that as well, right? Okay, just confirm this, hit confirm, and it is loading, right? Status. So let's wait for a few seconds, and it is done. Now click on this database access. And here click on this add new user, and let's give it a username. Let's say CNQ. Yeah, it is okay. And here you can just give a password or you can just auto generate it. And let's show this. Now just copy this up, right? We need to save this password because we can't remember this strange URL, right? So just here write PAWSWRD password and just assign. Just keep this URL for now, right? Okay, we will use this shortly. See, just remember this name and it will have read and write to any database. Okay, just add this user, right? Okay, now click on your cluster and it is still building or what? We can use this connect, right? Now we want to connect to our application. Now you can see we have this URL, and here we need to put a password which we just pasted. So just copy this entire thing, or you can just click here, and here we can just create a constant variable. Let's say const mongo URI or L, whatever you want, and just paste this URL. We should paste this inside quotes, right? So just put quotes here and just copy this password, control C, and replace this password with our original password, and you can just get rid of this for now, right? Okay, so don't worry, I will be deleting this project as soon as I publish my video, so you cannot use my URL. So make sure you create your own URL, right? Okay, so I think this is it for this video. We'll work more in next video. So till then, bye bye.